Opened in 2001, it lies on the same site and retains the name of the city's beloved former stadium. We're here at Empower Field at Mile High in Denver. Hi there, everybody. Thanks so much for joining us. You picked a fun one to tune into. I'm Kate Scott, joined by former NFL quarterback Brock Heward. And we've got two quarterbacks here, Brock, who are known for playing a very exciting brand of football. Not just throwing the rock, but taking it themselves, too.
Yep, these are two of the guys who really epitomize the direction that this position's going in the modern NFL.
Yep.
Pocket passers, they'll have their place. They always will. But a lot of teams look to somebody like this as a default. A great passer, but someone who can also mix in plenty of rushing yards and keep that defense honest.
Here to begin this one is Cameron Dicker. And off we go from Denver. Here's Tre'Von Smith with the return. And look at this return. He'll bring him down on the return as he gets this to the 33. So the Broncos offense getting set for their first drive. They'll be led out by the final quarterback taken in the first round of this year's draft. A lot of experience from Oregon and Auburn. It's Bo Nix.
Bo Nix entered this league as a grown-up. 61 college starts will do that for you. A ton of college experience. And Bo Nix is a facilitator. When he is at his best, that ball is in and out of his hands in an absolute hurry. If he were a point guard on a basketball team, he'd want to go up and down the court and get it out of his hands as quickly as he can. He's accurate, he's tough, he's experienced, and he's poised for this challenge of the NFL.
And the defense gets there to force a small loss.
You know why baseball coaches are called managers, Kate? Because they got to manage a lot of situations. And I've realized over time and talking to them, they love taking a situation, a game moment, and making it a team topic. That play by that corner right there, I know this is a head football coach, not a head football manager, but he's going to take that play. He's going to illuminate it to his team and show the fearlessness of his corner making that tackle.
And he's going to get this up close to the 40 before going out.
Hey, Kate, you know this from covering the Seahawks calling their preseason game when Pete Carroll was there. If he said it once, he said it 100 times. Stay on top, stay on top, stay on top. You'll give up a short little out route like that, but just stay on top of the deep threat.
Now Nix on third down. Almost an opening drive interception, but that winds up on the ground incomplete. It's going to bring up fourth down.
Hey, Kate, you feeling lucky? Well, the quarterback is, because he just dodged a major turnover. That was an easy pick that was simply dropped.
Broncos looking at a punt on fourth down, and Riley Dixon on to handle that. And they bring him down to put a stop to that return. So now we'll get a look at the other offense as the Chargers take the field. They'll be led out by the fifth-year pro who can really fill up a stat sheet, Justin Herbert.
Hey, let's be honest. The only reason the Chargers drafted in the top five was because Justin Herbert wasn't available all season long. An injury cut short his year, but it really didn't cut short his production while he was playing. Still over 3,000 yards and 20 touchdowns. Kid, I can tell you, this is one guy that I love. I mean, I love to watch throw a football.
Offense ready to begin this drive. First and 10. Here's the first give to Gus Edwards. And the middle holds. They don't get anything on the run. No gain there that time, and it's second and 10.
As that linebacker makes that tackle right in the middle of the field, all I'm thinking about right now, Kate, training camp. Because that's the middle drill right there. That is textbook. What you do in training camp, coming to life when it matters.
Second and 10 now. Completed here to Johnston. Now he's past the 25. And he will score. Touchdown, Los Angeles. The Chargers don't need long to take a 6-0 lead. Well, Brock, they could prove me wrong, but I don't think touchdowns are going to come that easily the rest of this game. But starting out, we all welcome the quick score.
Yeah, not a lot of energy exerted, right? Not a lot of their cards shown just yet. They only got a couple plays into their strategy, and they found pay dirt. A lot of mystery still to come with what they're going to do schematically. A lot of answers have to be found defensively.
That one splits the uprights. And they add one on to their first touchdown of the contest. Dicker all lined up and ready to boot it away. Marvin Mims now to return it. Coverage team gets him down at the 26-yard line. The Denver offense taking the field for their second drive. They didn't start the game off like they wanted, Brock. Still searching for that opening first down as they take the field a second time. They'll get this drive started. First and 10. Here's Williams to start the drive. And he's tackled after gaining a handful. First down play, nets him 5. It's going to be 2nd and 5.
The humble 5 to 6 yard gain on the ground. Not a huge gain. Not a game-changing play by any means. But one that keeps you on schedule and takes some of the starch out of that front 7.
Halfway to the marker, it's 2nd and 5. From the 31. Rolling into enemy territory. And he's going to be brought down after reaching the 43. That's going to pick up the first down after a gain of 26.
Well, that one was drawn up and delivered beautifully, efficiently. If it's not circled on the call sheet already, you better believe it is now.
Let's see how they attack this first down, Brock, from the 43. Play action with Nix. Flushed out of the pocket. He's on the move. Decent yardage picked up here before he slides down to avoid the tackle.
You know, Kate, back in the day, we had a slip and slide at practice for moments just like that. Actually practicing how to slide and get out of harm's way. Nice gain on the play and denied that defense yet another chance to take a shot on him.
2nd and 3 now. Up the gut they go with Williams. And he's able to drive this to the 29 before the stop. Call it 7 yards on the play, and that's enough for the first down.
They had the first down by a comfortable margin right there. Remember that play call. Put that one away. Could be a money play for them the next time they're in a similar spot.
To the line we go. They're set. 1st and 10. Nix off the play action. That one is incomplete. Couldn't hang on through the contact.
You know, the goal on a lot of these short throws is to simply let the receiver create some yards after the catch. That yak. Well, I think he was thinking about the yak before he actually secured the catch.
So after the incompletion, here comes the second down call. Shotgun snap to Nix. Escapes the pocket. He's going to keep it this time. Give him 13 on that play. And the Broncos will have a first down.
Well, I can promise you, that was the goal from the moment he took off. He kept his eyes locked on the chains. It's almost like he had a spidey sense. He knew exactly where to get in order to move the sticks and get that critical first down.
Nix with it on first. He had it for a moment, but a great defensive play to jar it loose. Incomplete.
Yeah, that's one that's going to haunt him. There's just no question about it. A drop touchdown in the end zone. Now comes the mental toughness part of it. You got to flush that play quickly so you can make an impact later.
Couldn't connect on first. It's 2nd down. Out of the gun, it's Nix. Complete to Mims. And he'll go down. Looks like they're marking him at the 11. Extra defender in the secondary now for the Chargers. 3rd down coming. Nicks from the gun. Complete beyond the marker. And he'll score. Touchdown, Denver. The Broncos reach pay dirt for the first time this game. So he looks to and finds the big fella, and his tight end takes it in for six.
Such a reliable weapon down in the red zone. You know, kind of reminds me like a point guard making an entry pass to that post player. When you trust your big people around you, and when a quarterback trusts his tight end like that, it makes a difference.
Will Lutz now on for the extra point. That one right down the middle. And we're all knotted up. Here's Lutz, set to kick this away. Kickoff taken at the 3. And this return gets to the 30 before he stopped. So the LA offense getting out there for their second drive. And after the impressive drive we just witnessed, you gotta imagine that they are hoping to respond with something similar.
Yeah, and I don't love to use the word can't, right? But this can't be a 3-and-out for this offense right here. They got to give their defense a chance to catch their breath and turn some of the momentum in the building.
First and 10 now from the 30. Shotgun snap to Herbert. Fires down the middle, and it is caught. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. They get 22 on that one. And it brings up an LA first down. One play in, and this drive is already in the enemy territory. First and 10, Herbert. Short pass caught by his tight end. And good tackle, but a flag is down, likely against the defense. Just a momentary loss of focus, a break in discipline, and not a good moment individually as he gets hit with that personal foul. Roughing the passer on that last play, and that's always going to lead to an automatic first down. From the pistol, it's Herbert. An alert play defensively there. He got a hand on it to tip it away, and that makes it second down.
Well, that throw, Kate, pretty clean out of his hand. Just looked like it didn't get through the defense clean enough. Somebody tips it away and saves a potential completion.
No dice on that prior pass. Here's second down. Herbert from the gun. He's on the move. Trying to get away from the pressure, but he can't, and they drop him. And that pushes him back. Third down coming up.
Pretty even match in this first half, and you're just kind of waiting. But you just kind of try to get a feel for which defense is going to come to life. And when you get that sack, that could go a long way to infusing some energy on that side of the ball.
Got to figure out this third down here. Working from the gun here, it's Herbert. He has the first over the middle. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. They rip off a big chunk of field, and it sets him up with first and goal. Dobbins gets it off the option. And as they bring him down, let's check the penalty flag. Well, partner, they say there's holding on every play. You just got to look for it, right? That time, though, we did not have to look too hard. So now, after being backed up just a bit, another first and goal. They'll run here following the penalty. And he'll go down. Looks like they're marking him at the 11. That's a 6-yard pickup. Second and goal, much closer for them now.
Fans love the long ball in baseball. It's like they got the home run derby. But you know what? Talk to managers and they will tell you small ball can win too. Singles and doubles, you add them up, you can win a lot of baseball games. Football coaches will tell you, you get runs of that length, it may not be a home run, it may not score points, but it can do some serious damage.
And he rocks the tackler. And he's able to bring this one down to the 4-yard line. 7 yards that time, and now it's going to be third and goal.
Well, you haven't given up the goal line yet, but this offense is moving closer and closer. Now might be the time defensively to get a little more aggressive, try to stick them with the loss, and make a difficult fourth down decision.
Third and goal. Here's Herbert. And he will score. Touchdown, Los Angeles. The Chargers break the tie here in the first. Well, Brock, you know this better than most. Sometimes these dudes can be a quarterback's best friend, finding the tight end in the end zone for six.
And it really has been that way for decades when you think about it, Kate. From John Mackey to Tony Gonzalez to Travis Kelce. The position can be such a mismatch when you're throwing for the end zone.
Dicker on now for the PAT. That one splits the uprights, and they'll continue adding to their lead. Dicker all lined up and ready to boot it away. Brings in the kick at the 9. And he's going to make this to the 28 before going down. Chance here for one final play before the end of the quarter. Drive begins with a run. It's Williams. And he'll get him a handful on that run as we've reached the end of the first. It's the end of the first in this AFC West showdown. It's a 14-7 game. We'll get you back to Mile High after this. We're back, and it is Broncos football as we resume. They have it on second and short. They stay on the ground with Williams. Just a single yard, but that's going to be enough to move the chains.
Kid, I'll give some credit to the defense there. Limited the gain to the outside, contained him for minimal yardage, but it was going to be tough to stop him from getting a first down as close as they were to the sticks.
First down now, ball at the 39-yard line. Throwing now, off play action. An alert play defensively there. He got a hand on it to tip it away, and that makes it second down.
I mean, you can see it right there. The trajectory of the ball changed as it was in flight. You know, on shorter throws, receivers, they can focus, they can adjust quickly. But on a long-distance throw like that, a tip, well, it really alters the course of the ball and makes it so tough to make an adjustment in time.
Knicks again on second and 10. Defender arrives right as the ball does, and the hit knocks it free, incomplete.
Well, that was almost one of those nice chunk plays you like to see in the NFL, Kate, before he was able to recover and provide the hit and ultimately dislodge the football. You like to see that physical edge and scrappiness to contest any kind of shot plays down the field.
On third down, here's Nix. He lobs it up, looking deep to the right side. And they really went for it on third down, didn't they? But the heave falls incomplete. Now they're facing fourth down. No luck finding his receiver that time. So that brings up fourth and long.
So many coaches love third downs, and they practice them so much, Kate. Why? Because they're the money down in the NFL. Whether it's a close game or already out of hand, coaches know, got to execute and convert on these third downs.
And a fair catch made here at the 17. That punt goes unanswered, no return there. And the Chargers are going to take over deep in their own territory. Drive starts out with a first and 10. Herbert. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he'll go down after pushing this up to the 29. Give him 11 yards, Brock, and a fresh set of downs.
You'll often hear it said, in my life experience, it's true, the NFL is a game of matchups, so much more than any level. And these tight ends, we see it time and again, are such a matchup nightmare down the field.
Now a give to Edwards, running left. And he won't get anything there. Several defenders nearby to hold him up. Call it no gain on that run, and they face second and 10.
Where one defender failed, well, his buddy was there to swarm to the ball and make that play just as it gets to the line of scrimmage.
Second and 10, need to get some positive yardage here. Herbert back to throw. Finds McConkey. And he's going to bring it up to the 40-yard line before he stopped. They get an even 10 on that play. And the Chargers will have a first.
Kate, when Bill Walsh was implementing the drag route with the 49ers in the 80s, it sounded the same way as it did with Mike Holmgren and me with the Seahawks in the 2000s versus man on a drag route run away. You see zone coverage, settle down, give your quarterback his numbers, and you can find a completion just like that.
Got a man over the middle, complete. And he'll be brought down a step or two shy of midfield. They're going to mark him at the 48. Nice spot here for the offense. It's second and one. Johnston brings it in. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. They get 22 on that one. And it brings up an LA first down. Shotgun handoff for Dobbins. And that's good yardage with a new set of downs.
Ooh, I like that call. I really like it with those sticks. You can keep them on the sidelines, and you get more than enough to get the first down.
He brings the offense up now for a first and 10. Working inside the red zone. Able to hit Palmer, complete. And he'll go down. Looks like they're marking him at the 11. After a good pickup, they've got second and 4. Straight ahead, here's Dobbins. And he's brought down real close to that goal line at the 1. A nice pickup of 11 there, Brock, and they'll have first and goal to figure out.
This offense will take that from their ground game every time. But I know, because I've been around this league a long time, runs like that they're really hard to come by. It takes everybody. And maybe a little breakdown there on defense, too, to take advantage of.
Trying it left side with Edwards. And he gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. The Chargers take a 13-point lead. Three drives, three touchdowns. It has been wash, rinse, repeat for them offensively, Brock, as well, we all wait for this defense to find a little backbone before this becomes a runaway.
Yeah, I'm a little torn up here in this booth because you're exactly right. Offensively, this is just machine, surgical. Defensively, you're running the risk of being embarrassed here pretty quickly.
Dicker on now for the PAT. That one right down the middle. And they'll continue adding to their lead. Dicker all lined up and ready to boot it away. Here's a return from the 7. And a decent return ends as they bring him down inside the 30. The Broncos running their offense out once again. And they'll try for better results this time around, Brock, after they had to punt it away last time out. And the drive will start out with a 1st and 10. From the gun, a carry by Williams. And he'll get it up near the 38-yard line before going down.
I got to really rack my brain, Kate, to remember a play, a run in this league that nice that doesn't end up getting an offensive first down. He did all he could to will this drive forward.
Let's see what they want to do here, partner. It's 2nd and inches. From the 38. Completed to Reynolds. And he's tackled with the 1st down yardage. Straight ahead with Williams. And he powers through the middle for a gain of 4.
You know, these are the kind of runs, Kate, that a balanced game plan and a balanced offense is built on. It gets you good yardage, it sets up your play action, and it keeps that defense honest.
2nd and 6 coming up here. From the 48. And he reaches midfield and starts driving into Chargers territory. That brings us to the 2-minute warning here at Mile High. The Broncos pushing for points. The Chargers into a nickel set, 3rd down. Nix. Tight end reels in the shallow throw. And out of bounds right at the 40-yard line. He manages a gain of 8 there. And that'll be good for a Denver first.
You know, Kate, they say a dog is a man's best friend. Well, a tight end that moves the chains on 3rd down, that's a QB's best friend.
New slate of downs to approach here from the 40. Throwing on 1st down, Nix. Fires over the middle, caught. And he'll get this down to the 33-yard line. Second and 3 now. They'll throw again. Nix. As a man, that's Courtland Sutton. And they stop him. He's marked down along that 18-yard line. Give him 15 yards on the pickup there. And the Broncos will have a first down. From the red zone now. He's got it, room to run. A nice pickup of 11 there, Brock, and they'll have first and goal to figure out.
Gosh, I really like this receiver on that drag route in particular. Why? Because he's a guy that creates after the catch. They don't close quickly. He could take it to the house.
They'll break the huddle and come up on first and goal. Shotgun snap to Nix. Buys time, rolling. And they get to him as he was trying to make something happen. We have a timeout called by the Broncos. That's their first. They'll have two left to work with before halftime. Second chance at six here. It's second and goal. Trying again, following the sack. And the cover just too good there. Didn't find a throw that he was confident in, so just throws it away. Third down coming up. Out of the gun, it's Nix. Gets it towards the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Hey, Mr. Quarterback, that's a throw that's got to go somewhere else. Double coverage was waiting for it. Think an interception to be had, and incompletion is still pretty good for the defense.
Will Lutz getting the call on fourth down to put three up here for the Broncos. This 32 yards out on the right hash. And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And that'll get him back to 11.
You know, you look at that third down play, looking back, and it really turns into a three-point play. It's why situational work is so critical. Coaches talk about it all the time. Sure, you love the field goal, but man, they would have loved a touchdown more.
Here's Lutz, set to kick this away. Darius Davis to return it. And he's going to make this to the 28 before going down. The Chargers and Quentin Johnson returning to the field. And eventually, Brock, one of their drives is going to fail to reach that end zone. But through three possessions so far, they have been perfect.
Yeah, and in order for that to happen, somebody somewhere on this defense has got to rise to the occasion.
Now begin this drive with barely over 25 seconds left. Throwing on first is Herbert. Got a man. Palmer has it. And he'll go down after fighting his way into the 32. Halfway to the marker. It's second and five. Throwing it just before halftime. On target to Dobbins. And he's going to bring it up to the 40-yard line before he stopped. We've reached the break. The Chargers visitors, but fighting out to an early advantage. Now we'll send things over to Orlando, Florida. Jonathan Coachman on standby, ready to deliver the EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Kate, thanks very much. And welcome in everyone to our EA Sports Halftime Report. These two teams heading out of the tunnel, and we're ready to get back to it. For the call of the second half, here is the great Kate T. Scott. Kate?
All right, thank you, Coach, and we are back and about set to begin the second half. Here's Lutz, set to kick this away. Return starts at the 3. And this drive will start inside the 25. The Chargers are being led back out on offense by Justin Herbert here. And this is some quality film review right here. Look at this, couple of touchdowns, good amount of yards too. He's been moving them down the field like only he can, putting together quite the game for himself in the process. They're out and set, first and 10. Shotgun snap to Herbert. Quick hitter complete. And they're gonna bring him down just beyond the 30 at the 31. Second and 3 now. Give to Dobbins to start the 3rd. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains.
These aren't the plays that will lead highlight reels, but they're the ones that win you ball games. What a nice game by the back. And now his offense can go in any number of directions on 1st and 10.
Here's 1st and 10 from the 34. Working from the gun here, it's Herbert. Completed here to Johnston. And they push this down to the opposing 47-yard line. That'll go for an 18-yard gain. And the Chargers will have a 1st. Now an inside handoff to Dobbins. And he drives into a pile of defenders and is stuffed right at the line. No progress on 1st down, and that'll bring up 2nd and 10.
These linebackers of today, they are so quick. They're so twitchy. You don't get a body on them in a hurry, they're going to stick you right at the line of scrimmage.
Herbert from the gun. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he's going to be drugged down, looks like at that 37-yard line. They come through with a nice gain of 10 and a 1st down.
Sometimes you're looking to push the ball down the field. But as I've said before, the crumbs lead to a cookie. And you never go broke taking a profit, and those big tight ends will often find you those easy check down yards.
Here's a give inside to Edwards. And it took a couple of guys to haul him down there after a gain of just 1.
The one thing I could say positive about the execution of that play is at least he didn't go backwards.
They'll come to the line here, 2nd and 9. Motioning the tight end now. On 2nd down, here's Dobbins. And once again, he doesn't manage much before getting brought down. Give him about 3 yards, and now they're going to have 3rd and 5 to figure out.
You make that call to just give yourself a fighting chance on 3rd down, Kate. Take at least a little bite out of the big meal between them and the 1st down marker. And that should make this upcoming call a little less daunting.
Herbert now to throw on 3rd. Hauled in by Dobbins. And they haul him down just a foot or two shy of the red zone. And that one goes for a gain of 11. And it brings up an LA 1st down.
This dude's just simply got a nose for the marker no matter how they get him the ball, Kate. Hand it to him, and he sniffs out that first down. Get it to him on a screen, and it's no different. He surges ahead and keeps this drive moving.
He brings the offense up now for a first and 10. A give to Dobbins out of the shotgun. And they bring him down at the 7-yard line. 14 yards on a nice play there, and it gives them first and goal.
Kate, don't think for a second this is time you step off the gas. You can feel this defense, right? They're on their heels. And now's the best chance to go push the envelope and get aggressive.
Four downs now to get in. Here's first and goal. Back to throw. Here's Herbert. He completes it in traffic. They're lining up on the doorstep. Second and goal from inside the one. Running behind center with Edwards. And just gets back to the line of scrimmage. Just not quite enough to break the plane, and now it's third and goal at the one.
Well, now things get a little dicey for this offense. One down left before a big decision to make. Do you continue to try running it against a front that stopped you, or are you now forced to put the ball in the air?
On the ground, it's Edwards again. And he gets in, touchdown! The Chargers grow the lead coming out of halftime. And he is all smiles down there. He's got his second rushing score this game, and they've got an even bigger lead in this second half.
Well, we know it because we call these games week to week, Kate. Almost every single one of them seems to be a one-possession nail-biter. To build this kind of cushion and to do it with the strength of his legs, yeah, they're worthy of those smiles down there.
Dicker on now for the PAT. That one splits the uprights, and they'll continue adding to their lead. Dicker all lined up and ready to boot it away. Has this at the 6. Coverage team gets him down at the 26-yard line. The Broncos offense all set to go. And down double digits, Brock, field goals like we saw in their last drive aren't going to move the needle as much as they need to. Offense ready to begin this drive, first and 10. Second half starts with a run by Williams. And he's tackled for a short gain. 3 yards on the first down play, and that brings up second and 7. Nicks from the gun. Finding Reynolds. And he's got a decent gain before being brought down. Third down, 1 yard to go. Running for the marker with Williams. And he's tackled for no gain. Now we'll see the medical team head out towards a Charger who's still on the field and in some pain. Here comes the Broncos punting unit. Riley Dixon, the one to kick it away. And he finally gets a hold of one here. This is hit far. And they bring him down to put a stop to that return. The Charger offense making its way to the field. And taking a look at these highlights, Brock, just a reminder of the type of game that they have had throwing the football. It really has been the key to their success.
Yeah, they've just not only stayed on schedule here, Kate. Man, they've made some music, right? Great rhythm.
Yeah.
Not just ahead of schedule, but huge plays have followed. We've seen a lot of different looks and wrinkles throughout this performance, and it's been a joy to watch.
They'll get this drive started. First and 10. Beginning on the ground here with Dobbins. And he gets a few on the plunge forward.
Got to be rush hour, Kate, because there's a whole lot of traffic up the middle right there. He ran right into some gridlock, and he could only manage a few yards at most.
Second down now, 7 to go. A play fake. Now Herbert to throw. Nothing there left side as it ends up incomplete. Not on the same page with his tight end. And that takes them to third down.
That is normally a gimme for this offense, these short throws. But the defense, well, they had just enough influence on that play to force the incompletion.
On third down, Herbert. Johnston brings it in. And he crosses the sideline a yard or two beyond, looks like the 30. Give him 8 yards on the play. And the Chargers will have a first.
There's no routes on the old proverbial route tree, Kate, that takes more trust than throwing an out route. You're throwing it to a spot and believing your guy can get there.
It's a new set of downs for him at the 32. It's a handoff here to Edwards. And he's able to power this forward, but they stop him after 2 yards.
That's a pretty good stop on first down. This defense now gets a chance to dictate, and that's what all the great defenses want to do, Kate. They want to dictate it on their terms and not just be reacting to what the offense is always doing.
From the 34, Hurst there to grab it. And he's tackled with the first down yardage. Just one quarter remaining in this one. It's not quite over yet, but it'd take a pretty miraculous comeback. We've got a 3-score game as we get set to start the fourth quarter. They'll head up, first and 10 from the 42. Dobbins trying the right side. And he has enough room to gain about 4.
They'll come away happy getting that type of output on most run plays. It's a sign, well, they're getting some good push up front, and this running back is seeing the lanes and paying them off.
Second and 6 coming up here. Sending a receiver left. Here's Dobbins again on second down. And he'll only get this one up to about the 47. They pick up 1 on the run. Need more, though. That takes him to 3rd and 5. Throwing from the gun. Escapes the pocket. He's running for it. He manages a gain of 8 there. And it brings up an LA first down.
You know, that's one of those little mental Rolodex plays. Right before the snap, you know if the read isn't there, that option isn't there, you can use your legs to make the adjustment and go get the first down.
New set of downs for him from the 46. They'll run on first down with Dobbins. And he's charged towards the line. That's right around 3 yards. Second down now, 7 to go. Again, they'll run with Dobbins. And once again, he doesn't manage much before getting brought down. Just 1 yard on the play, though. That leaves him with third down and 6 to go. They run the counter with Dobbins. And he's brought down for a loss.
You know how we hear about teams and quarterbacks avoid targeting a stud cornerback, just throwing away from him? Well, maybe they should avoid running it anywhere near this guy. He's having no issue stopping these plays cold.
So on fourth down, here's J.K. Scott on to punt it away for the Chargers. And they were giving him no chance to return this one. It soars over the sideline, deep in enemy territory. Looks like a right around the 8. Denver ready for another offensive possession. They were only on the field for 3 plays their prior series, Brock. Let's see what changes they make to take over here. Drive starts out with a 1st and 10. Nix looking to throw. And there's a man there. It's intercepted. And he's going to go. It's a pick 6. Defense getting in on the fun, Brock, with that fourth quarter lead as they provide a nice little boost there with the pick 6.
Yeah, you could feel some of the desperation of this offense. And when you get into that mode, it is danger time. Defenses love to take advantage of it. I always say to you, Kate, play fast but never in a hurry. You can't be rushed offensively because you can often be rushed into mistakes like that.
Dicker on now for the PAT. That one right down the middle. And they'll continue adding to their lead. Well, Brock, hopefully some short memories on offense as they get it right back here on the kickoff after that pick 6. Kickoff taken at the 3. And in the end, he's able to get it to what used to be a touchback. It's at the 25 after the return. So here comes the Bronco offense. And they didn't have much time to recover from that pick 6. Need short memories here as they head back out. And the drive will start out with a 1st and 10. Back to the air, Nix after the pick. Falls to the ground out left, incomplete. Almost a completion of the wrong team there. And it sets up 2nd down.
You feeling lucky? Well, do you? Well, he should, because the quarterback got away with one right there. That was an easy pick dropped by the defense.
So after the incompletion, here comes the second down call. Play action with Mix. He's gonna loft one deep to the left. That's cut at the 25. They rip off a huge chunk of field as the downs reset.
If only every completion could get that kind of result. That's good enough to knock a defense flat on its back.
Sets him up nice and pretty at the 25 following that big play. Throwing on first down, Nix. Got his man on the in, complete. And this one does not go far. Second down now, 7 to go. Nix off the play action. Defense is too much here. The Chargers drag him down. And that pushes him back. Third down coming up.
The call play action would have been better to actually give it to him on a carry right there, Kate. The front was fooled for about a split second, if that. And that play call ended up working in their favor as it leads to a sack.
Extra defender in the secondary now for the Chargers. Third down coming. Now Nix. To the left sideline, complete. Well, third and 15, you don't see many of those picked up, partner, but they found a way.
That's just a gorgeous corner route by the wide receiver. I bet you'll find, Kate, in the annals of football history, the best corner route runners as receivers. We're also the best slant runners, the best post runners, because it's all about change of direction, and that was put on display right there.
And it's caught. And he'll push this upfield and earn them a new set of downs. From inside the one, here's first and goal. They'll look to run with Williams. And he runs this one in for the touchdown. The Broncos making the scoreboard look a touch better. Javonte Williams, the touchdown. Well, Brock, this one has not been good to them so far, but they are still fighting and able to get in there for six.
Just a drive that was all about scratching and clawing. As much as anything, Kate, it was just a pride drive to go and get your job done.
Extra point try now from Lutz. That one splits the uprights. And they're a point closer now on the scoreboard. With time ticking away, they prepare for a must-get onside kick. And no problem for the Chargers, they cover it up. And he has it to the 42 before they make the stop. Well, I guess they kind of had to do it here, Brock.
Yeah, it's called a have to. Yeah, kind of have to at this point of the game, huh?
Okay, but like most things in this game, it did not work out for them.
Yeah, let's face it. Even if they do recover that, probably not going to find a way to win. But this is a time where you work on things, where you do build to the following week. Got to find a way to flush this because it's just not been their kind of game.
They'll head up first and 10 from the 42. Straight ahead, here's Dobbins. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. They get 20 yards out of the play and move the chains.
No frills, nothing fancy. That was just a good old offensive line dominated in the trenches. And that sprung him to get to the second level and beyond.
A new set of downs forthcoming. It's first and 10. And they'll let the clock run all the way down and expire. Everyone was set and at the line. The quarterback just didn't snap it before the play clock hit zero. They'll have to come up with 5 extra yards now after that first down flag. Running it after the penalty. And all he can get is 1 yard. Ran that right into the defensive front. They only get a yard that time, and we have reached the 2-minute warning. Offense to the line for second down. Running it again with Dobbins. And he carries it for a big gain that gets him down into the red zone. He gets them half of what they needed, so after a 7-yard gain, it's 3rd and 7.
Well, he was a second late to break this one downfield. Still, a quick bounce to the outside and a counterplay that gained some good, positive yards.
They'll throw on 3rd and long. And this one is dropped and incomplete. He had the pick in his hands, couldn't hang on. It's going to be 4th down.
Oh, that was such an opportunity lost. They were looking for a way out without giving up any points on the series. And instead, well, he just couldn't quite hang on.
And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And that stretches the lead to 21.
Yet another shot across the bow of a ship that's already sinking here, Kate. He could have made that field goal. Heck, he could have turned around and kicked it directly at his coach because it feels like they've got this one in hand.
Dicker all lined up and ready to boot it away. That's going to be taken in at the 8. They'll bottle him up as he gets the return to the 30. Denver set to take the field on offense. And this a final opportunity to make things a little closer in that final score. First and 10 now from the 30. Shotgun snap to Nix. It's taken in by Williams. And he'll get it up near the 38-yard line before going down. After a good pickup, they're set up with 2nd and short. From the 38. A sideline shot snagged by Sutton. And he'll go out of bounds after a pickup inside the opposing 40. A big play, 23 yards to move those chains.
Now here's a spot where the timing's got to be absolutely perfect, Kate, between the quarterback and the receiver. That throw is made before that receiver's ever thinking of coming out of his cut. Too early, it's incomplete, too late, and it's headed the other way.
Completed to Reynolds. And they haul him down just a foot or two shy of the red zone. Oh, And they've got themselves another first and 10. They'll throw again. Nix. And he just hucks this one away. Wasn't going to risk a throw or force something. It brings up second down. Out of the gun, it's Nix. Quick hitter complete. And he's able to get this down to the 13. Hurry up offense now as time runs down. Here he is to throw on third and 2. And he'll score. Touchdown, Denver! The Broncos get it back to within 2 possessions. Cortland Sutton, the touchdown. We've seen him do a lot more to reach the end zone on a catch, Brock. That one was kind of fed right to him.
Yeah, they say the running backs have a nose for the end zone. You know who else does? Every skill guy out there. Yep. Because they want to put a touchdown on the board.
Extra point try now from Lutz. That one right down the middle. And they're a point closer now on the scoreboard. No time making this all but impossible, but they're going to try for the onside kick here anyway. And this kick is covered by the Chargers, and that should salt this game away.
Each of these guys on this hands team, well, they're handpicked, no pun intended, for the assignment. And they need the guys out there who can always be relied on to go bring in that onside kick without incident.
Victory formation here. Looks like they're going to take a knee on first down. And he's going to take a knee. Now the Broncos take their third and final timeout. That's all they had, so the offense free to start running the clock down now. Lining up to take a knee on second down. And they'll kneel this down.
Nothing left to do now, Kate, but celebrate on one side and watch on hopelessly from the other. What a hard-fought effort to get to this spot. And now you can enjoy the victory.
So the Chargers take this one on the road. And partner, I know you took down plenty of division rivals in your NFL days. Heck, your conference opponents back in Washington in your college days. Always makes the win a little bit sweeter when it comes against a rival, doesn't it?
Yeah, there's just a little bit more emotion. There just is. Yeah. I mean, you try to keep every game level and no opponent's bigger than the other, but familiarity does breed a little more contempt, and we could feel it today, and that's why that W is a little bit sweeter.
So for my partner, Brock Heward, and our entire crew, I'm Kate Scott, saying this has been the NFL on EA Sports. So long, everybody.